State up in State College, Pennsylvania, a living legend.
Well, I never studied at Penn State either.
You didn't study, huh?
I just beat people up. There I got a scholarship.
Brian Adams of the NWO comes out. I want to make a few announcements here. We talked about the Road to Spring Break. Well, next week on March 16th, the Road to Spring Break ends as Spring Break begins at Club La Vila in Panama City, and that's where we'll originate WCW Monday Nitro. On Monday, April 6th, Monday Nitro comes to Miami in the Miami Arena. Tickets will go on sale this Saturday at all Ticketmaster outlets. Mean Gene and Miss Elizabeth will be at FX Music on Biscayne Boulevard, North Miami, Saturday at noon. Conan will be at Specs Music International Mall, also at noon, as we open up ticket sales for Monday Nitro in Miami, Monday, April 6th. Tickets go on sale this Saturday. Still to come tonight, information about tickets in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, Norfolk, Virginia, Colorado Springs, Colorado, and Fargo, North Dakota as well.
You're darn tootin'.
Yes, you are. Well, we're going to see a singles matchup here. Brian Adams of the NWO out, and he'll face Chaos of High Voltage, along with Rage and Ringside, two of the most powerful young men that we've had. But guys, let's not go any further without talking about the comments by Hollywood Hogan. We want you fans at home to call your friends. I know you're going to say, hey, all my friends are watching Nitro anyway, but still, call your friends, let them know what we've got for you later on tonight. Hollywood Hogan, Scott Hall, and Kevin Nash in a six-man tag against the Macho Man Randy Savage, the Giant, and World Champion Sting. Now, that is later on in this program, live tonight.
And that difference of opinion between Hollywood Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage just seemed to go up a couple of levels. Did you hear Hogan during that last interview? The NWO is now rid of Savage, and we are done with you for life. I don't think Savage thinks the same. I doubt whether he concurs.
I think Savage feels that he wants to be in charge of the NWO, and he's trying to rid the NWO of Hollywood Hogan.
Yeah, the mind games, I mean, are phenomenal here. I mean, if you're a member for life, then you cannot ever be thrown out. But Hollywood says he's thrown out, but Macho thinks he's in the new world order. I think they both want to be the number one top of the pecking order.
Brian Adams back to the attack once again, to the small of the back of Chaos.
Look at Adams, another man who sold his soul.
Big Brian Adams, among the newest of the NWO recruits, and the New World Order certainly refortifying their ranks recently.
Yeah, they certainly have, if you take into consideration not only Brian Adams, but Scott Steiner as well. They may have been growing in numbers, but certainly at the top, Hollywood Hogan and the Macho Man Randy Savage, they are having their problems. That kick hit the man right on the trapezius, on the shoulder that time, and sent Chaos down.
Yeah, there's no doubt in your mind when the New World Order beefs up its recruiting efforts and starts buying new souls that there is something fishy going on. So I don't care what they say. If they're rebuilding their troops, that means they expect some to be leaving.
Well, they certainly got a bonus here, and one Brian Adams, not only one of the biggest men in our sport, but one of the most dangerous as well. I mean, the wrestling fans for years have known about Brian Adams, his ability in the ring, and we're seeing just a little bit of it right now. He's rough, he's rugged, he's very confident, he's cocky, he fits right into the NWO mold, Mike.
Total domination in this matchup by Brian Adams against Chaos. We see the other half of High Voltage, Rage at ringside, trying to deter Brian Adams, but not successful. There's the belly-to-belly in mid-ring.
Yeah, Brian Adams, when you get a man this big that's got good balance and is that powerful, it's a force to reckon with. And Rage is very good, but not showing any offense at all here.
Adams, once again, back to the attack, just showing the world what the NWO is made of. They are made of some of the greatest athletes in the entire sports world, not only in pro wrestling, but in the entire sports world. And Brian Adams, look at the length of holding Chaos and drops him down with a gutbuster. What a move that was!
And that's a long way down.
And what an impressive show of strength by Adams. Cover, hook the leg, gets just a two count.
And he's, let's not only, let's not forget that he's doing this against a man who is multi-talented and strong like Chaos. Chaos, a jawbreaker. That's been really his only offense so far. Bryan Adams reels now back to a cutter.
Hey.
Rage out. That's what you got to do. You got to double team the NWO because they'll double team you. And how about that? A running left-handed lariat.
Just exploding across the ring with that clothesline and the cover.
Chaos, 1-2. Didn't hook a leg that time. Had lateral press only. No combination on that one.
Hard to pull up a leg on a man that tall. How tall is this guy? He's a big, big man.
6'7" tall, isn't he?
6'7" is what they list him as, and he's back to the ropes now. And Chaos will shoot him into the right side, to the midsection. Chaos now, don't celebrate too much against these guys. One of the things about Bryan Adams has not only been his ability in the ring, but his perseverance, his drive. The man can come back as a cover, 1-2, and he kicks out at 2.
Yes, but he's missing one important ingredient, Tony. His soul. He sold it to Hollywood.
They all do, except for the Macho Man Randy Savage, it is. And oh, he takes on both members of High Voltage as Rage had come up on the top. I tell you, had Rage hit him, it would have been a disqualification. Would have ended the match, but the match will continue as Rage is sent on the outside. Chaos goes in, and oh! Tilt-a-whirl.
Wow, what a slam in stereo.
How about that? It's over. A tilt-the-whirl slam. Oh, foot to the face. Bryan Adams is not finished. He has run through Chaos, and now he's got Rage. So Charles Robinson's going to count him out there.
What's he counting him for? He's not in the match.
Yeah, he's intimidated is what the referee is. You know what they're about. You know what the NWOs will do to referees.
Well, I know what these guys that these new recruits will do to impress the New World Order.
Fans, more to come on WCW Monday Nitro. We're live, and we're from Winston-Salem. Still to come, a big six-man tag.
He's a man of very few words.
What an incredible scene we have.
He lurks in the rafters.
Slowly turns and points. And
he hides behind a face of paint.
That stinks.
He shows no emotion.
What's been going on in this man's mind?
Nobody knows where he comes from or where he'll show up next.
Steve from the top.
Get yours.